So I hope you'll have your grammar notebook ready. Now, as you know, gender is when you're talking about the sex of the whatever object you are talking about, of the noun, yes? Now, whether it is a male, whether it is a female, or whether it is neither of these, that tells you the gender of the noun. Now, in a noun, there are four types of genders. The first one is masculine, feminine, neuter, and the next one is common gender. Okay? Now, when you're talking of masculine gender, you're talking of anything that is male. That is, anything that is male. Like, you're talking of a boy, you're talking of a man, you're talking of father, you're talking of uncle. All these are males. Now, these are called masculine gender. Clear? Now, going to feminine gender. Feminine gender is the name of anything that is female. Like aunt, mother, sister. Yeah, all these are feminine. Princess, queen, all these are feminine in gender. I'll just read what I've given. The name masculine gender, the names of male persons or animals are called masculine gender. Example, lion, boy, father, prince, uncle, waiter, emperor, bachelor, etc. Feminine gender. The names of female persons or animals are called feminine gender. Example, aunt, sister, witch, lioness, actress, mistress, landlady, negress, etc. Now, negress is a negro, a black person, an African, okay? So, the male is called a negro and the female is called a negress. Now, neuter gender. When you're talking of neuter gender, is something that is neither a male nor a female, that it doesn't have any sex at all. Okay, it's neither a male nor a female. Now, what is it then? It is an object which has no life, but it comes in noun. Now, this may include even your abstract nouns. Yes, like lifelessness, yes, jurisdiction, such things are all neuter gender. Like lifeless things like a table, like a rock, like a marble, pen, pencil, all the book, all these are come under neuter gender. Now, even material nouns, collective nouns, you cannot say that it is a male or it is a female. That's why they are all come under neuter gender. So let me read. Nouns, neuter gender. Nouns which refer to members of a species which is neither male nor female. So they're neither male nor female, is called as neuter gender. They generally include lifeless objects. Material nouns, collective nouns, abstract nouns, lower animals and very young children are considered to be of neuter gender. Now, lower animals and very young children, generally, like when you're just talking of, I found a puppy on the road. It was crying with pain. You don't say she was crying or he was crying, because a puppy is very small. So, when you're talking of something that's generally very small, like the baby was crying because it had hurt its toe. You don't say she had hurt its toe or he had hurt the toe. You say it had hurt. Okay. That's because the baby is very small. Clear? Okay. Okay. Let's read the examples. Example. Table, clock, stone, glass, cloth, cloud, paper, computer, star, etc. The sentence, the baby, the baby was crying because it was hungry. So, you're calling the baby as it. You're not saying she or you're not saying he. Now, the baby has to be a male or a female, correct? But still, because it comes in the very young children category, you said or you called it. You did not say he or she. The second sentence, I could not move the table as it was very heavy. Now, here the table is neither male nor female, that's why you said referred to it as it. Now the last one, common gender. Now common is something that could be male or could be female, or maybe both are included in that. Like when you talk of children, when you say the word children, when you say the word students, students include both boys as well as girls, that is male as well as female. When you talk of children, they include male as well as female. When you talk of parents, so parents is one is a father, one is a mother, correct? So one is a male, one is a female, but they are common. That's why you know, because you're not talking of only male or you're not talking of only female. Yes, you're talking of something common. Any of the genders, or maybe both the genders, are there in the group that you are talking about, like parents, class, students. Clear? That's why it is called common gender. So now let me read. Common gender: nouns which refer to a member of a species which can be either male or a female is called a common gender. Example: child, friend, cousin, enemy, servant, etc. That girl is my neighbor. So here you're not saying anything, he, she, nothing. That boy is my neighbor. So both are your neighbors. Maybe it's a boy, maybe it's a girl, maybe it's an uncle, maybe it's a friend, maybe it's an aunt, you don't know. Okay, so but it could be of any of the masculine or feminine. Okay, note: a lifeless object known for power, strength, greatness or violence are often commonly treated as masculine. So anything that is considered to be very strong, yes, powerful, such things are considered, just taken for granted that they are male or masculine. Like for example, the sun is very powerful, no one can stop it, correct? So that's why you say he when you're talking of the sun. When you're talking of a strong wind, you're talking of the storm, generally you say he. Now for example, sun, wind, storm, death, etc. You cannot stop any of these. You cannot stop the sun, you cannot stop the wind, you cannot stop death, correct? They have their own strength, they have their own ability which no one can stop. See the sentence: the sun shines with all his brightness, death lays his icy hands even on kings. So you're calling death as males by using the word his, you're calling a sun as male by using the word his. Clear? Okay, we go to the next page. The second point: lifeless objects known for beauty, gentleness, gracefulness, weakness, peace, hope are often treated as feminine. Like something that looks beautiful, that looks very elegant, that makes you, when you look at it, you feel, oh, how graceful, how nice. Yes, these things are considered to be as beautiful. Like for example, here over here is the moon. Yes, the moon, even though it gives you light, it is not very strong like the sun. It will not burn you like the sun. Correct? So that's why you treat it as a feminine gender. See the example? Look at the moon. She looks so beautiful. Okay. Now, and this is just a list of a few of the masculine and feminine genders. I will just read it to you. All of these, there is no hard and fast rules, like as I had given you all rules previously for other things. Now here you have to learn them by heart, and many of their spellings also change. Okay, so you have to make a note of the change in the spellings. Okay, first: baron, baroness; manager, manageress; mayor, mayoress; peer, peeress. Peer means friend, okay? Fox, vixen; poet, poetess; negro, negress. I just told you a black person is a negro, an African. Waiter, waitress. See, you remove the waitress. E is not there. Murderer, murderess. You can make a small star next to waiter so you know that the change, or you can underline there T and R together in waitress. Jenny, jackass, Jenny ass; bull, elephant; cow, elephant; monk, nun; cock, sparrow; hen, sparrow; hero, heroine; lad, lass; buck, doe. That's a female deer, okay? Generally, you call them as, if you're talking of only deer, you will say deer. You will not, now when you want to specify, what, if it's a male or a female, you will say buck and you will say doe. Okay, that is common gender will be deer. Well, as if you know exactly whether it's a male or a female, you will say buck for male and doe for female. Okay, the next one, heir, heiress. You know what's, who's an heir? Heir is the one who is next in line to inherit everything. Means, like say after Dhirubhai Ambani died, who was the next to run his business? His two sons, yes? Mukesh Ambani and Anil Ambani. So they were the heir to the Ambani empire, yes? The his whole business. Understood? So who is next in line? Like after the king, who is next in line to the throne? The prince, correct? Or maybe if he has two sons, both the princes, correct? So they are the heir to the throne. The next one, 18th one, bachelor, spinster, uncle, aunt, wizard, witch, author, authoress. Okay, the 18th one. I hope you know bachelor and spinster is someone who are not married. Yes, someone who is not married is called a bachelor. And if he's a male and if it's a female, it's called a spinster. Moving on to the next page, emperor, empress. Here again, M and press. E is removed. So you can underline P and R so you know the change over here. Master, mistress, actor, actress, sultan, sultana, landlord, landlady, host, hostess. Who is a host and who is a hostess? I will watch your TV shows, correct? So many TV shows you have, Dance India. You have people who actually talk. They introduce on the stage. You may have the judges sitting in their place, but you have maybe one or two anchors, what you call as, okay? So they are your host or hostess for the day, yes? They are the ones who will see to everything. They will see to all the needs over there, of needs of the participants, needs of the judges, whatever is to be done. That's why they are called the host and the hostesses who take care of you, okay? Now, if you're having a party in your house, if you're a male, you are the host of the party. If you are a female, you are the hostess of the party because you are in charge of the party. You are holding the party in your house and you are the one who are going to really look after your guests. Okay, next one. Duke, Duchess, Tsar, Tsarina. The Russian king is called a Tsar and his queen is called the Tsarina. Milkman, milkmaid, ram, eve. These are a type of goat. Okay, goat. General family, that is common gender, goat. Well, as it's a male, then ram. Female, then eve. Okay, the sheep. Sheep family. Not goat, sorry. The sheep family. Okay, next is colt, filly. Again here, you're talking of horses. Common gender would be horse. Well, as if it's a male, it is a colt. And if it's a female, it's a filly. Generally, you're talking of a small-sized horse. Yes, when you're talking of colt and filly, it's a small-sized horse. Okay, the next one. Nephew, niece. You know cousins, what do you say? Bhanja, bhanji. Okay, that's nephew, niece. Drake, duck. Gander, goose, drone, bee, earl or count. Both are female is countess, horse, mare, gentleman, lady, shepherd, shepherdess. You know who is a shepherd who takes care of the sheep? Yes? Okay. Now your exercise. I've given you only 10. Here, write the opposite gender of the following. All may not be there, but some of them which are not there are common. Yes? So, in case you have a doubt, like you know what is a feminine gender of king. It's not there in the list that I've given you. But you write it because it's very easy and you know. Some of them are in the list, some of them are not. So, if you are not sure of the ones that are not in the list, you can ask me. Don't show me your whole homework, but there are just 10 words in this. 10, okay, so you do it, write this, whole exercise or the notes that I've given you in your notebook and do this. Write the opposite gender, only 10 are there. If you have a doubt or whatever question you have to ask me about the opposite gender of any of these words, you can message me. Okay, thank you. Do have a good day.